DNA tools are great, and there's actually been many tools that have come out this year, one of which I want to go over today and show you how it can be really useful. So this is the shared CM tool, which many of you are familiar with, except now you can use two people instead of just one to help narrow down your search. So the tool can be found on the dnapainter.com website. If you just go to tools, there's going to be a list, and it is the first one on here, the shared CM tool. And you'll notice here it has, hey, we can go to the new version where you can enter two values. So let's start with just clicking on the tool and just entering one value to see a couple of different things to make sure we can see how this is working. So I'm going to use siblings because I happen to have my DNA for my siblings. And I looked at several matches. So here's this first one where I shared 393 centimorgans. And on this, you can see that, hey, it comes up and says, there's a 73% chance it is one of these. And that is the great-great aunt, half-great-niece, great-great-niece. That's nice. My brother happens to share 484. You'll notice that, hey, this changed. Instead of 73%, it's now 89% chance that it is one of these. Likewise, then, the others change. So, for instance, this is only a 7% chance that it's the half-great-niece, whereas with mine, it was a 27% chance, so significantly more. And then finally, I had this about 0% chance it's these other two, which is completely different from my brother's, which is 4% chance that it's one of these others. And so wouldn't it be great to actually be able to combine these two to eliminate some of these possibilities? Well, that is what this new version does. And over here, you can see on the other versions, there's this new with the option to add a second amount. I'm going to click on that. Now, you'll notice that this looks similar to the first page, except that there is two boxes here to put something in. So you can see here that there are two boxes to enter information in. I'm going to start with mine, 393. Now, you'll notice it didn't come up with the probability table, but it does come up with the map of different relationships. And you can see all of these here are possibilities with 393 centimorgans. Well, now what I can do is I can put in my brother's 484. And let's see how this changes. Now, if you're looking carefully, you'll see that actually this has disappeared off of it. This has disappeared off of it. And I think this has disappeared off of it. In other words, it has taken out of possibility those relationships which don't meet both of our DNA. Now, this is somewhat similar to what Watto does, except this only does it for two. And this is showing you a lot of the possibilities in this nice chart format. And it's not just with these big ones. So let's just go and let's change this up a bit. I'm going to clear these. And we'll start with another match. Now, I shared 298. Now, you'll notice all these are possibilities with 298. Well, my brother shared 280. And if I do 280, you'll notice that nothing has actually changed here. And that's just because 298 and 280 are so close together that really all the possibilities for one are the same possibilities for the other. So one thing I would say whenever you're using this tool is try to use it only for matches where there is a somewhat of a disparity between you and your sibling. So let me go to my next match here. I happen to have 209. I shared, you know, quite a bit, and look at all of those that are at 209. Well, my brother only shared 93. When I look at that, there have been quite a few that are eliminated as far as possibilities. So again, we're just using shared DNA from two brothers and how that affects which ones we need to look at. Let's do another example here. I share 140 with one match, and there's, as you get lower in numbers, the number of matches possible or the number of relationships possible increases, which makes this tool important because I can put in what my brother shares here, which is only 59. And you can see it has eliminated some of those. So it's not necessarily eliminated a lot or half, but it's eliminated several. Now, we might use some age deduction to guess that, hey, it's not going to be two generations or more older than us. So I could eliminate these ones right here. And it's not going to be two generations or more younger than us. So I could eliminate those right there. So I'm left with these few right here in the middle for this. But the other thing that you can do with this is really any two matches that are along the same generation. So for instance, let me take a look at me and my first cousin, a couple of different matches. We'll do a match that I share 365 with, and he happens to share 347. Now, there hasn't been much change here, but this is where it's important when you know what relationship you're looking at to see. So for instance, I'm looking at myself plus a first cousin here. Our second cousins are going to all be second cousins to me and my first cousin, okay? But first cousins once removed, well, that's going to actually obviously eliminate any of his children because he wouldn't be a first cousin once removed with them, but only with other first cousins. So it would also eliminate his siblings, okay? So it's not going to be nieces and nephews of him, even though they're my first cousin once removed, or my niece or nephew, they're not going to be part of this. So if you're using first cousins, that's usually pretty easy to keep straight. Once you get to second cousins, that's going to be a little bit more difficult, but you can still do it. Let's look at a different match here. This is again with me and my first cousin. I share 212 centimorgans and he shares 121 centimorgans. Here's with just me, if I just had myself, but now with him, there's a few relationships that have gone away because they don't fall into that set of what we expect from that relationship. And again, this can go all the way down. For instance, let me do this one of 133 for me. A lot of relationships there. On this relation, this one, he happens to share 267. So you can see it has eliminated some of those relationships. So this new tool, or actually this addition to the tool on the Shared CM Project tool, is very useful. Again, you can use it with any two people who are on the same relationship plane. And by that, I mean your first cousin, your sibling, your half sibling, third cousin, fourth cousin, anything along that, you can use this tool for to help isolate what relationships these unknown matches may be to both of you. Now, I liken this tool to Watto. This is sort of like a really scaled down Watto because you can only put in two relationships. But in a lot of cases, those two relationships, along with some other data, like how old that match may be compared to you, might eliminate many of the possibilities so that you know where to focus your research. Now, if you like this video on the Shared CM tool, then you can watch another video to learn how to use it more up here. And be sure to like and subscribe to our channel.